So welcome everyone. Today is the day that we have the final webinar in the series, Euro Practice series on flexible electronics. So today we scheduled a talk of Wim Kisteraensen from Quad Industries. So Wim will talk a bit more on the flexible printed electronics, a world of opportunities. So I hope that you liked all the previous webinars as well. So the first one was given by my colleague Chris Meaney on an really introduction into the world of flexible electronics. Then 2 weeks ago, we had an exciting talk from Vincent Barlier from Pragmatic, who dove into the world of their technology, so the flexible integrated circuits. And like I said, today we have scheduled a talk by Wim. So Wim Kisteraensen is an expert. He's a doctor. He's an expert or a PhD. He's an expert in the field of flexible and stretchable electronics development and manufacturing. He obtained his PhD in electronic engineering from the Ghent University in Belgium in 2009 for his work on the integration of passives and active components inside flexible circuit boards. And further, he has experience in business development and printed circuit board manufacturing. He joined Quad Industries in 2014 as an R&D director to coordinate strategic initiatives with strong focus on exploring new technologies and applications in the field of screen printed electronics. So having said that, I wish you all a nice webinar, and Wim, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Romano. Thanks for this introduction, and also thank you for the opportunity to have this to be part, let's say, of this webinar series on flexible electronics. So the goal of today is to give you some more introduction of on flexible printed electronics, and also to showcase what is possible, let's say, with this printed electronics technology. Let me start with just some small outline. So I will start with some company introduction. Who are we? Who is Quad? And then the main topic of today will be indeed to give you more flavor of what printed electronics involves and what is possible with that. And therefore, I will just highlight different use cases where our printed electronics are used. And I think this will give you the best insight or feeling with what is possible with this printed electronics. So I'm representing here Quad Industries. Quad is headquartered in Belgium. We are an SME company with a turnover of around 5 million euros. Headquartered in Belgium, but having also a production facility in Slovakia. So Slovakia is focused on sheet-to-sheet production. Meaning that there we are focusing on the mid-volume market and also the labor-intensive manufacturing. And then last year we invested in Belgium in a brand new roll-to-roll production facilities. So in Belgium we are focusing on the high-volume markets and the automated production. What products will be addressed later in this talk. But now let's say, who is Quad, or why? What could we do for you? Is basically we are a company focusing on one hand on the development and also on the manufacturing of printed flexible electronics. Having said that, let's maybe just start with the definition of printed flexible electronics. As it's a bit self-explaining, I would say printed electronics is actually a set of printing methods which are used to create electrical devices on a wide range of substrates. And basically, there are many different printing techniques which exist and which are even used for printed electronics. And to give you some examples, I will give here some three examples. You can consider digital printing, like inkjet printing, where basically droplets of inks are deposited on the substrate. Think about your printer at home. Well, you could consider the same technology with functional inks, so with conductive inks, and also manufacture printed electronics in that way. A second technique is screen printing, and that will be the technique which is also the focus of Quad Industries, where you actually deposit your ink using a screen, and your ink is pushed through the screen and deposited on the substrate below. But some more about this in the next slide. And the third technique I want to highlight is flexoprinting, and that's done the other side of the spectrum, where you need to consider very, let's say, high volume applications. Like, for example, this technique is used a lot in food packaging. So the very high volume packaging, very low cost packaging, there you will find a lot of flexoprinting. And the principle is that basically what you do is you deposit a uniform layer of ink on a roll. So this doctor blade defines the thickness of the ink. This ink is then transferred by physical contact to I would say a structured roll, and the ink is transferred on this 3D structures on the roll, and then this small parts of ink are then deposited on the substrate. In general, I would say digital printing is mostly still let's say low volume, anyhow, mainly sheet to sheet. Mainly, I would say. Screen printing is both sheet to sheet as roll to roll manufacturing, and flexo, that's only focusing on roll to roll high or extremely high volume. In printed electronics, screen printing will be still the most commonly found method for manufacturing these printed electronics. And the main reason is, on one hand, the screen printing inks themselves, the materials you need, are most mature for this screen printing technique. And also, let's say, the methods or the machinery is are very established. So what is now the basics of this screen printing? It's a printing technique where you will use a mesh to transfer ink onto a substrate. And this mesh contains a photosensitive layer, which is defined and it's structured. And some parts are blocked on the screen, other parts have opening, and with the squeegee you will push ink through the openings on your substrate, and in that way have a pattern transferred to the substrate. Here I included a picture of a screen where you will see it's a screen has here an aluminium frame with a mesh, the yellow one, and on top of that you have a photosensitive layer which has which is then illuminated and has a certain structure. Through these openings, you will push the ink using a squeegee. Now looking for the mouse. So such a squeegee can be used to push the ink through the screen, and you copy actually the image which you structured on your screen. You copy it in ink or with ink on your substrate. And here you see a picture of one of our screen printing machines. So you find again the screen which is inserted in the machine, and the squeegee pushes, in this case it's a silver ink, through the openings of the screen. Here I included a picture of an Atma, which is one of the brands of a screen printing equipment. So that's how it looks like. Now coming back to Quad. So we are a manufacturing of printed electronics, mainly using screen printing, but we also have strong focus on development of, let's say, this printed electronics technique. So let's maybe first have some words on this. So it's important to know we have a strong focus on research and development, because this printed electronics, there is not so much standard yet, certainly not for the novel applications for our for this printed electronics. So that's why developing new applications for printed electronics do require a lot of support from your manufacturer. And we do a lot of R&D, and that's in that way, together with our customers, so on bilateral project base, we like to be involved in the early stage to take a concept from prototype up to the volume manufacturing stage. And besides this bilateral projects, we also do quite some funded projects where we work then on developing new technologies within bigger international consortia, also with research institutes like IMEC, Holst, Fraunhofer, for example. So those are two important pillars, I would say, for our R&D department. And in general, we have defined four strategic innovation domains, and those will also come back in my presentation later on. On one hand, we focus on stretchable electronics, as shown in the picture here. Printed electronics will be a valid technology to have a direct integration of electronics on textiles, on wearables, for example. In mold electronics is also another very nice example, where we will then print on thermoplastic materials, which then can then be overmolded. And in that way, you make a nicely integrated electronic part inside or fully integrated in the plastic part. Printed PTC heaters will also be addressed later on in this presentation. And another one is pressure sensing. So those are a bit the four main innovation domains. And in general, I would say our R&D is strongly focused on finding the proper material combinations and processes to make this integration of textiles in this wide materials. In terms of manufacturing, I mentioned already before, we are a screen printing, or we focus on screen printing. That's really the core of our manufacturing capabilities, I would say. So this screen printing is both roll to roll as sheet to sheet. It should be clear that we work in very well controlled environments to guarantee sufficient quality of the circuitry, of course, or the products we make. And also more and more high precision is really needed for this printed electronics application. We work with a very wide range of materials. In general, if you look to the functional inks, typically you will find silver for the interconnects, but these will be combined with carbon inks, with transparent inks like P-DOT, with silver chloride, for example, for medical electrodes, and many more. So those inks are then combined with, again, a wide range of substrates. Standard, you will find PET, so plastic substrates, polycarbonates, TPU for stretchable applications, and also, again, many more. So the core is screen printing, but of course, in addition to make full products, you also need another set of other techniques and complementary techniques. And then this includes laser die knife cutting to cut parts to size. A lot of lamination is often required, so to laminate different layers on top of each other. We also do pick and place assembly in-house, so we are able to do SMD assembly on our printed circuits. So instead of soldering, which you will find back on copper-based technologies, we will rather focus on conductive gluing of SMD components on our printed substrates. And then furthermore, we do of course also a lot of testing that can be optical inspection, can be end-of-line testing, full functional testing. This is also something which is of course needed. I'm also quite proud to share this slide because last year we invested in Belgium here in a brand new production facility, only focusing on roll-to-roll. So we have now a very high-end roll-to-roll printing line here in Belgium where we are able to achieve an accuracy below 50 micron with full integrated cleaner camera systems, inline testing, optical inspection, lamination. So it's a fully integrated production line. And another investment in Belgium is a roll-to-roll laser cutting line, which is then again complementary. So you not only need to be able to print, but also to do lamination, roll-to-roll laser cutting, all roll-based to really address these high volume markets. Having said that, here you find a glance of different products which we make now in volumes for our customers. I will not go too much into detail because most of them will be addressed in the next slide. So this ranges from user interfaces to a lot of sensors which can be printed. Skin patches is a very hot topic at the moment, and we see a considerable increase in interest in the market and a number of projects for wearable skin patches. Printed heaters you find back, and also antennas, for example. We do a lot of big antennas for automotive in volumes up to 100,000 and more per product per year. So a really wide range of possible applications you will find for this printed electronics. And each application has or for each of these applications, you will find an advantage of using specifically this printed electronics compared to traditional electronics. And I will try to highlight this also in my story when going to the different use cases. Markets we serve, so the wide range of applications you will find back also in the wide range of markets. For us, for our strategic goal, growth, automotive and healthcare are certainly one of the key target markets. But you will find also we also do a lot of user interface touch holes, for example, for home appliances, a lot of industrial applications. So a very wide range of market segments we are active in, I would say. Now I come to this main part of my presentation to really dive into the real applications a bit more into detail. And I want to start with the user interfaces. And there I will let's say discuss three, let's call it generations of user interfaces. So the membrane switches were the oldest parts or oldest products, oldest user interfaces on the market using printed electronics. Next, you will find more and more touch foil, touch-based interfacing. And a third one is linked to this in-mold electronics will be 3D formed user interfaces. So I start with the membrane switches. I think you will recognize these type of products. These are products which have a multi-layer construction consisting of, let's say, a graphic printed front foil. And below that, you find two printed circuit layers. So these are two layers of printed circuits, which are laminated on top of each other with a spacer. So the conductors are separated from each other with the spacer. This means when you press the surface, you bring the two conductive circuits to each other and you make electrical contact. And in that way, you can detect the operation of the user interface by the user. And at the backside of such a product, you find back or you will find back an adhesive layer. But the core of this product is really a screen printed electronics layer, where you will typically find a silver ink protected by an isolator printed on a plastic PET foil. And this is actually, to me, the oldest printed electronics product out there. So we are manufacturing these already for more than 30 years. So in that sense, printed electronics is already a very established technology. And you find these membrane switches in a wide range of applications. So a lot of medical equipment use these interfaces, a lot of industry also. I included some pictures of products we make, so a variety of client charging cables for charging for automotive, remotes also do use sometimes membrane switches. Bottom right, you see a grasshopper from Viking using our membrane switch, and even in the military you will find our membrane switch to be placed around the displays in the airplanes. So a wide range of industries do use these membrane switches, and because it does offer quite some advantages. So a membrane switch ensures a seamless interface. You don't have this mechanical button, so it's very easy to clean. Think about the medical applications or outdoor applications. You don't have this water penetration. It's a reliable solution. It's very established. So for example, we do qualify all the products for over 3 million activations without any failure. It's cost effective, easier to integrate. So these modules can then be easily integrated in the equipment where it needs to be. And it can be easy customized. Eh? So the graphic layers, the functional layers, it's just adapting the printing patterns, I would say. So very easy to customize to your needs. So in general, the main use case for using printed electronics here would be cost. And you print on foil, so it's a very thin solution you find for these membrane switches. So the next generation in user interfaces was, of course, following the trend of having all this touch interactive with our smartphone, then more and more interfaces also become touch based. And so here's two pictures of a coffee machine. It's on the, let's say, on the middle picture is a coffee machine, then industrial vacuum machine. So basically, these interfaces consist of a front, which can be a plastic, can be a glass, which also have a graphic print. And behind that, you will find a printed circuit. So this, again, screen printed circuit will be then laminated at the backside of this graphic printed front. This is a very suitable technology for 2D surfaces, enables touch interfacing. But okay, still requires some integration of the film and the front. So it's not a fully integrated version, but it's a very nice technology to have this touch-based interface. And here you see a typical product, which is not exactly the same design, of course, but which we do now into very high volume for automotive. So it's a touch sensor where you will find individual buttons. So all the individual buttons can be easily identified. So each button has a trace to detect on capacitive based the interaction with the finger. And also a slider is shown here. So here you find a slider structure to detect sliding of a finger over this area. And basically, to make this product, this is already quite complex product because it consists of multi-layer printing of silver for the interconnects again, isolator to isolate different printed layers from each other. We also use transparent conductor here. I'm not sure if it's really visible on your screen, but for example, the bluish shine you see, it's because we use P-DOT, which is a transparent conductor. This enables to have this touch buttons be backlit. So in that way you have this, maybe like shown on my previous slide, you can have this button structure defined and you can backlit these buttons then. Think about your center console in your car. You will typically find such type of foils. So yeah, it's very critical to be able to do finer and finer printing to integrate all these buttons on one foil. You need to ensure the transparency. That's why printed electronics has certainly its place here, because we can easily integrate electronics on a transparent film. So if you compare with a polyimide-based flex foil, yeah, you cannot use it for these transparent backlit applications, for example. And furthermore, yeah, you need to be aware that the tolerances are very tight and include coatings, and you can still add some adhesive. So there is a wide variation range still possible. But this is something which is already widely spread on the market, also fully accepted by the automotive. So that's also a key enabler, so that automotive is already very well known and acquired with this printed electronics technology. And let's say that the next generation of user interfaces is to look into, I would say, 3D surfaces. So we started this research already in 2013 in the European TerraCell project. And we were actually one of the first manufacturers showcasing a 3D form part with integrated printed electronics. And basically, here the use case was that we replace a turning knob by a 3D shaped turning knob, that in that way the user still has the intuitive feeling of operating a turning knob. So he knew where to put his fingers without having all the mechanical parts anymore and the complexity of a turning knob. So here again, a concept drawing of this demonstrator. And basically, here, printed electronics really do offer a very straightforward way of integrating electronics in such 3D shaped object. Because what we do is we screen print, of course, with the suitable material. So that's this material research which is needed. We screen print with suitable inks on thermoplastic material. In this case, it's a polycarbonate. This polycarbonate can be thermoformed by high pressure forming or vacuum forming, which is a standard technology in the polymer processing world. So this polycarbonate can be thermoformed and then overmolded to have a fully encapsulated plastic part. And as mentioned again, it's simply by printing electronics on a thermoplastic material that you fully integrate it. Imagine if you need to do this with a copper-based circuit. Yeah, it's a struggle to have this very nicely and seamlessly and cost-effectively integrated. So here InMode Electronics offers really the design freedom. So instead of having an just a 2D shape or front, you can think about recessed buttons so that the user knows where to place his fingers, so that you can keep, for example, in the automotive, keep your eyes on the road and you know, okay, now I'm at the proper spot and I can do the touch up operation. Or we can use have this 3D shape turning knob, as mentioned before. It's very intuitive to let's say to increase the volume and to have a turning knob like shape still. So it's very intuitive, but it's very thin, it's very seamlessly integrated, and yeah, avoids all the mechanic parts also. So very nice example of using or advantage of printed electronics, I would say. Also important to mention, in for this applications, mainly for the automotive, we partner with Novares, which is a tier one automotive supplier, and where Quad is then focusing on, let's say, the printed electronics foils, so the manufacturing of the foils. Novares will be focusing then on the 3D forming and overmolding of these foils. Now I come to a second application. So we had this three different type of user interfaces. And the next one which I wanted to show here is printed heaters. And more specifically, printed flexible PTC heaters. And PTC heaters, they use a PTC ink, and this stands for positive temperature coefficient ink. This means that this ink has the property that it increases in resistance when the temperature increases. And when using this, we will be able to, let's say, to have a self-limiting heater produced in that way. So what we do is we print connectors or bus bars with silver, again, as the most standard material, on our foil, and we combine it with PTC in the different islands. So in that way, we make a PTC heater. And the biggest advantage is that this PTC effect ensures a self-regulating effect. So in this way, we make a self-regulating heating element, because when you switch on this heater, it's cold and it has a high power because the heating elements have a very low resistance. And then by increasing of the temperature of this individual heating elements, the resistance will increase. The resistance will increase, so the current will drop, the power will drop, and it will settle at a certain equilibrium point. And in that way, but I will maybe showcase here one practical example. So this is a heater developed for a battery pack, size around 27 by 37 square centimeter. And here we used a PTC ink settling at 60 degrees to ensure that when heating the battery, that you don't overheat the battery cells. So when switching on this heater, it will never go higher than 60 degrees. So that's the safety aspect. Use case for this is industrial equipment, which needs to be able to, and which is electrical driven, which needs to be able to operate also when it's freezing outside. So then you also need to be able to charge your battery when it's cold outside. And for having an efficient battery charging, or to be able to charge your battery even, you will need to heat it first. Advantages mentioned already, the self-regulation effect is a clear advantage of using this PTC inks. It's a rapid heating because you have a very high power in the beginning when you are under your settling temperature, and then it settles and the power is reduced. It ensures a very uniform heating with this nicely distributed, let's say, heating elements. And at the end, it's a very lightweight, because you take a foil, you add some ink, so it's a very thin foil, which can be easily integrated inside the application. And in this case, yeah, And I did not mention this before, but printing is a quite sustainable way of manufacturing electronics because it's an additive manufacturing process. Imagine that you want to produce a simple PCB with one or two layers. Yeah, you need almost 20 processing steps, including also harsh chemicals to etch away the copper and the plating techniques and so on. With printing, you just print the metals, the materials where needed, and in two or three production steps, you have established a multi-layer simple electronic circuit. So the sustainability is certainly also a valid argument to go to printed electronics. Application for these printed heaters, you find them already inside the automotive. So seat heating, armrest heating, older interior parts heating become more and more important when considering to move to the electrical driven cars. Battery heating, I mentioned this example already, floor heating, but also heating of humans, eh? So patient heating or be even firemen or policemen needing to operate outside also are looking more and more to integrate heating in the garments. And this concludes my slides about the heaters. And then I come to the last part of my presentation where I want to showcase some use cases in wearable health applications. And if you look to this wearable health application or personal health applications, yeah, also there you find a wide range of different use cases. And I split a bit in three big groups. So on one hand, you have the wearables as such, which I consider to be a separate device, not integrated inside your garments or worn on the body or sticked on the body, but really a separate device. Then you have the group of smart patches, which are really patches which are can be stuck to the body to monitor people. And then a third group will be smart textiles, where we look into integration of electronics inside the textiles. If we come to the wearables, then I have one use case highlighted here. It's the Arion. So this is a product which is on the market. Our customer is a Dutch company called Autogear. Their product is a smart shoe insole. And this insole enables to monitor basically the interaction of a runner with the ground. So in that way, the running technique can be analyzed. So the key aspect of this shoe insole is a sensor integrated inside foam or leather of a shoe insole. And this sensor, this printed sensor, is combined with an electronic, training pod, they call it. So an electronic module, which will contain all the ASICs and the readout electronics. So we will have a printed sensor, then the electronics module reading out all the data from the sensors. And then a third pillar is then the app, which gives the user then some insights in his running technique and behavior. Zooming in to the, shoe insole. Yeah, if you look to the requirements to develop such a product, this is quite challenging and was very new to us a few years ago, because basically the question is, yeah, can you develop a sensor which slips seamlessly in the shoe? So it should be very thin. It should survive all the bending and shear forces which are present when moving, let's say. The shoe is also a very wet environment, so it should really, it's quite a challenging environment also in that extent, and should be very thin. So we aimed at having a sensor below 0.4 millimeter. And it should last for more than 1,000 running kilometers. So quite severe challenges. But we managed to do this using, again, this printed electronics. So we print, again, silver on our on PET. And we combine here with FSR ink. So the I don't know if you see it very well, but the black areas here, it's an FSR ink, force-sensitive resistive ink. Which is used there as pressure sensing. So basically this FSR ink is very special because it's a carbon ink, carbon particles blended in a stretchable matrix, This means that in at rest, there are few contacts between the particles inside the ink, and this means you will have a high resistance. When you apply pressure, you compress the stretchable matrix, and more carbon particles will make contact, so the resistance will be reduced. And in that way, you have a force-sensitive layer, enabling, in this case, really to monitor the pressure distribution inside the shoe, let's say over time or over distance. So, this required a lot of iterations together with the customer. So that's why I also mentioned in the beginning that we like to be involved in the early stage to think along with the customer, to tune the materials really according to their needs and to optimize. And in that way, we were successful to bring this to a really commercially available product. So this was an example of a wearable as a separate device. And now I come to smart patches. I will showcase two different types in this case. The first one is a patch which we developed here in Flanders within a COVID care at home project. So this patch is also on the market. It's even already part of a medically certified solution. Recognized here in Flanders or in Belgium, sorry, to enable the earlier release of COVID patients from the hospital. So the idea was that patients recovering from hospital can go, and it's on the average 3 days earlier than before at home, but they are still 24/7 monitored at home. So advantages are quite clear, because for the hospitals, we were able to reduce, let's say, the pressure on the healthcare system to reduce the number of patients, COVID patients, still at the hospital. And for the patients, you optimize, let's say, the comfort, because the patient can recover at home in his well-known environment, but still be sure that he is 24/7 followed up by a medical professional. So his state is really narrowly followed up. So this was a very nice and relevant development we did. And here you see the consortium. So we had put together a lot of technology partners, where Quad is the manufacturing of a smart patch. Then we had Henkel and Nitto providing materials for the patch. Also Melexi providing, let's say, components for temp sensing. Then we had Byteflies providing or developing the electronics to read out the patch, and also the cloud service, connecting it with Televic healthcare system inside the hospitals. And then we had a lot of hospitals, now already more than 20 hospitals, subscribed to this program to follow up the COVID patients. So, zooming into the patch, here you see a picture of such a patch which is applied on a COVID patient. So, it's a two-lit ECG patch where you find a patch and again a rigid module. So, this patch enables to monitor the heart rate, give insights in, of course, the status, the heart rate status of the patient, but also the sleep patterns, activity patterns, even breathing. And this disposable part is the patch, and the rigid module will be reused. So here you see an exploded view of the same solution. So we have the rigid module, which is reused, and it just contains all the, for example, the ASICs and the readout electronics. Advantage is this module is reused, so you do not need to dispose all this expensive components, and also from ecological point of view, you only dispose the printed part and not all the electronics devices. In terms of printing, it's quite a unique material combination we have here. Basically, what we do is we print dedicated stretchable inks on a TPU, a stretchable substrate. We print silver for the interconnections. On top of the silver, we will print an isolator to protect the printed tracks, also to isolate it from the skin. In the electrode area, we will print a silver chloride for the ECG readout. And this is then integrated on a medical grade textile. So you will find then, a patch with integrated electronics. On top of the printed electronics, we will apply a skin adhesive. And also in the electrode area, you will find a hydrogel or a dry electrode material to ensure a good electrical contact to the skin. So this is a very unique material combination we have here, and which is really appreciated by the market now, and which is really enabling a lot of new applications. So here I showcase some of other patches we have produced for different other customers. This includes stimulation patches. This includes sleep apnea monitoring patches. This includes even patches for monitoring animals, and many more are in the pipeline. So the philosophy for this setup is always, we have a disposable part, mainly containing the EXG electrodes. So we do EEG monitoring, ECG monitoring, etc. And then you will combine with the reusable part, which is then a separate electronic module. Another patch I want to showcase here is a patch which went further into the, in terms of integration of the electronics. And basically this patch was developed within a European project called NextGen, which started in 2016. And here we work together with NXP and Holst mainly on this patch to integrate a lot of functionality on one and the same patch. So the idea was to develop a smart patch as an, let's say, an on-body multi-parameter monitor. So basically, what we did here is showcase this different functionalities all integrated in one patch. So what we find here is, on one hand, an electrochemical ion sensing to detect the chloride content in sweat of the user, a galvanic sensor, so between these two points, a galvanic sensor to measure the skin resistivity. Here you find a capacitive sensor to measure the skin hydration. And these sensors are combined with one single chip from NXP, having also an integrated temperature sensor and also enabling an NFC interface. So you will also find on the patch a printed NFC antenna. And of course, we also need some power, so also a battery was integrated. And here you see a picture of this patch. So very nicely, fully integrated solution for all these wide range of functionality on one single patch. And here, yeah, I would just want to showcase here, this is a fully disposable version. So in this case, when the patch is disposed, also the ASIC and the battery is disposed and in the electronics waste. So different setup, having the pros and the cons. The pro is the further integration. The con is, of course, the ecological impact and the cost impact. This is still a side view of the build-up, mainly highlighting that we also, that it was very innovative, also integrating even an absorbent material to have really a flow of sweat over the electrodes to detect the chloride content. Now I come to the very last part of my presentation and of this wearable solution. It's the smart textiles. For me, this will be the next wave for printed electronics in the wearable domain. The smart patches are now on the market. They are really coming to the market. We are doing volumes of products or of certain products already a few thousand per month. So these volumes are, let's say, are getting there and are increasing. So this is already a soon to be established market, I would say. The smart textile for me will be the next wave. And of course, this imply a completely new requirement, because now you not only need to have a stretchable electronics, but you also need to have a washable electronics. And yeah, I can assure you, develop electronics to survive a washing cycle and to be resistant to the harsh chemicals during a washing cycle, and possibly also to be compatible with tunnel drying, really does imply some research there. Here you see an let's say the outcome of a funded project which I can show because it's out there in the public, which we did, which we started in 2019. And this was actually a smart shirt to monitor lung patients, so COPD patients. And the main thing which we established here was to have an interconnection between rigid modules, which can be removed, so, and sensors. To realize this interconnects by using printed electronics. And to me, this is a much more straightforward way of integrating electronics into the garment compared with integrating conductive wires, for example. Because what we do is we print on TPUs. And actually, TPU is a very well known in the textile industry because these materials are used to do imprints on shirts. But what we do is we don't use graphic inks, but we use functional inks. And in that way, by using established, let's say, textile manufacturing processes, we can here be successful in integrating, let's say, conductive interconnects. And yeah, you can imagine if you compare this with integrated conductors, which are integrated in the textile and which you need to still to connect and solder and so on. Yeah, this also imposes different challenges. So we have now several other projects now on this topic, and this is certainly also a very promising application domain for printed electronics. And in this way, I come to the end of my presentation. So I hope to have given you some insights on printed electronics technology and what is possible. Main message is by printing on a wide range of materials, you enable to, let's say, to integrate basic electronics, I would say. You will never replace high density PCBs by a printed version, but basic printed or basic electronic functionality by direct integration, by printing on a wide range material, is really a key enabler for many of these applications, I would say.